Give this, give that. And some of the biggest devils, they give to charity too.
That's right.
That don't mean you're saved.
That's right.
They don't have to have love to give. They just give.
That's right.
Some of them do it because of obligation. Some of them do it because of the tax break. Amen. Amen.
That's the truth.
He said, even though you give all that stuff, don't be fooled.
Amen.
It don't profit you nothing spiritually.
Amen.
Maybe you'll get a break off your tax, but spiritually it don't profit you nothing.
Amen.
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 It's like bodily exercise. It profits little.
Amen.
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 Read.
Charity suffereth long.
This is what love is. Amen. You ever, hold it a minute. You ever felt someone's spirit that they you come in contact with and you can feel that the person treating you cold?
Amen.
Mm-hmm. You ever had that experience?
Oh, yes.
You feel like what you do to that person. Amen. You might not have done nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And the folks just have stuff against you just for no reason.
Amen.
Sometime in the job, in the workplace, one will get jealous of the other.
Yeah.
And start treating the person wrong.
Amen.
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 Like Cain and Abel.
Amen.
That's right.
He rose up and slew his brother. To get me 1 John, you hold that spot right there. Get 1 John 3 and 14 real quick. And they treat you so cool. I know how it feels because I'm Indian.
Mm-hmm.
I'm from Guyana, and I feel it all over. I feel it from, amen, I feel discrimination from both sides.
Amen.
Amen. So I know what it's like.
Amen.
I'm used to being mistreated.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
We know that we have passed from death unto life.
See what it says here? We know that we have passed from death to life.
Amen.
This is how you know whether you're saved or not.
Amen.
Whether you're going to heaven or not. Death is hell. Life is heaven. How do we know? Read.
We know because we love the brethren.
Because we love the brethren.
Tell the truth.
Amen.
That's how you know.
That's how you know.
Amen.
And you know when you have something in your heart against someone.
Amen.
You know.
Amen.
Right. Amen. You feel it in your own heart. That's your heart.
Amen.
You should know what's inside of there, what you feel and how you feel.
That's
person,
right.
Person.
That's right.
This is how you know. You know for yourself. See what God's word say?
Right.
This is how we can find out whether we pass from death to life.
That's right.
You don't love your brother, you got something against him? And he ain't did nothing to you? You don't love your sister, you got something against her?
Amen.
She ain't did nothing to you?
Amen.
You better forget about heaven.
That's right.
Amen.
Tell it.
Amen.
Amen.
You be like that baseball player running around the bases and the umpire done called you out.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Read some more.
And he said, he that loves not his brother abideth in death.
You got something in your heart against your brother. God said you abide in death. Read.
Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer. And ye know that no murderer have eternal life.
God called you a murderer when you hate your brother.
Amen.
You could just have one thing in your heart against your brother and God called you a murderer.
Murderer.
Amen.
Amen.
Read some more.
It says, hereby perceive we have the love of God because he laid down his life for us.
That's right.
And we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren.
Look what God did for us. He laid down his life for us.
Amen.
And he's telling us, if we got that same love, that's God's love, that he laid down his life for us,
that's right.
We would lay down our lives
that's
for
right.
our brother.
That's right.
Amen.
Well, this is getting tight, but it's right.
But it's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And it's needed.
We're getting quiet. Amen.
Amen. Keep on preaching, preacher.
Amen.
Keep on preaching.
This is how you know whether you pass from life to
Amen.
Death.
Amen.
He laid down his life for us, and he's telling us we got his the same love. Ain't no different love.
No.
That's his love. And he did that for us.
That's right.
Why can't we do it for our brother? Why can't we forgive one another?
Amen.
Didn't he say in in Romans 12 and 1, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your body a living. Sacrifice Amen. While you're alive, Amen. Holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable. Service. Yeah. Be right. Not transformed to this world, but be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by right. the renewing of your mind,
That's right.
that you may prove that good, acceptable will of God.
Thank you, Lord.
That's why Abadiah, we come to church to change the way we think.
That's right.
So we don't think like the world out
Amen.
There.
Amen. Amen.
So we can be different.
Amen.
So we can hear the truth of what God has to say about it.
Amen.
Not what Elder Dannie has to say, what does God has to say about it?
That's right, that's right.
We all got to measure up to this.
That's right.
This plumb line, we all got to walk it.
That's right.
We all got to measure up to this.
Amen.
Amen. For all of us to be saved.
Yes.
From the pulpit all the way down to the back door.
That's right.
We all trying to get to the same place. We haven't made it yet.
No.
Apostle Paul said in Philippians 3:13, I count not myself to have apprehended. He said, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind, reach forth for those things that are before. He said, I press to the mark.
Press towards it.
Every one of us has a press.
That's right.
A mark that we got to press our way to get to.
That's right. Amen.
To the prize of the high calling of God in Christ. But as many as of us be perfect to be thus minded.
Thank you, Jesus.
If we be otherwise minded, God would reveal this to us.
Amen.
That's what the Lord wants us to do, to press to reach that mark.
Keep on pressing.
Don't be satisfied.
No.
Psalm 17 and 15, he said, I behold thy face in righteousness, and I shall be satisfied
Thank
when
you.
I wake with thy likeness.
That's
what David said. He said he ain't going to be satisfied until he's just like Jesus.
That's right.
Until he get all his faults, all his wrinkles out. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Read verse 4 again.
Charity suffers long and is kind.
Charity suffers long. How long? As long as you got it, you're going to suffer.
Amen.
If you ain't got it no more, you ain't going to suffer.
Amen.
How do you know you got charity? How do you know you got love? How do you know you got God?
Amen.
Can you suffer? Babatia.
Jesus.
What does the book say? Charity suffers long. Peter didn't get it. He said, well, how many times long? How long? 7 times 7? 70 times 7? Tell me how much so I can mark it down. Jesus gave him a big old number, 7 times 70.
Uh-huh.
In one day. Can you do that, Peter? Forgive that one person that many 490
uh-huh.
times.
Uh-huh.
Some folks can't forgive them twice.
That's right.
I just don't forgive them last Tuesday. Now he's up there doing the same old thing again.
That's what they say.
I done forgive him about on that. And you know what? I ain't going to forgive him until he come and apologize to me.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
He didn't say he had to come apologize.
That's
right. Your heart. That's your the junk that's in your heart.
Amen.
You're walking around with that stuff.
Amen. Amen.
That's your heart you're trying to get clean.
Amen.
Proverbs 4:23 says, keep your heart with all diligence. Out of it come the issues of life.
That's right.
That's your job, is to keep your heart right.
That's
and not
right.
let things get hatred and malice and envy get inside of your heart.
That's right.
Amen.
All this stuff can come in people's heart.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right. Set up camp.
You got to suffer long.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
1 Peter 4:1 said, for as much as Christ suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourself likewise. Having the same mind.
Same
he that had suffered in the flesh.
Amen.
Has ceased from sin.
Amen.
Jesus.
1 Peter 4:12, beloved, think it not strange concerning these fiery trials.
Uh-huh.
That it's a trial of faith.
That's
some strange thing happens.
That's right.
But rejoice.
Hallelujah.
And so much you're partaking with Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed,
That's right.
you may rejoice with exceeding joy.
Thank you, Lord.
1 Corinthians 4:16, if our outer man perish, the inner man is renewed not month by month, year by year, day by day.
Day by day.
For a light affliction, of a fear, which is but for a moment,
Hallelujah.
Working in us a far more exceeding and eternal way to glory.
Thank you, Lord.
For we look not at the things which are seen, because the things which are seen are temporal, But the Tabatia Mosiah, the things which are not seen are eternal. But if this earthly house of our tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heaven.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 4:7, that the excellency of the power may be of Christ and not of us.
Amen.
But we're troubled on every side, yet not in distress. We're perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Always being about in the body, the dying of the Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
The life of Christ may be manifest in our bodies.
Amen.
Psalm 34:19, for many the afflictions of the righteous.
Many.
But the Lord deliver him out of them all.
Out of them all. Yeah.
Yes.
Job 13:15, he said, though he slay me.
Yes.
Abadiah, yet will I trust in him.
Yes, Jesus.
Isaiah 53:10, and please the Lord to bruise him.
Amen.
Isaiah 53:5, but he was wounded for our transgression. Y'all can sit up there and look at me all crazy, but God has given me his word.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Psalm 107:20, he said he sent his word.
That's right.
To heal them.
That's right.
And deliver them from all their troubles.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everything. Isaiah 53:5, but he was wounded for our transgression. Bruised for our iniquity.
The chastisement
of our peace was upon him.
Yes.
We destroyed the
mountain.
We obey.
Hallelujah.
We heal.
Hallelujah.
1 Peter 1:7, that the trial of our faith being more precious than gold that perished, though it be tried in the fire, may be unto praise, honor, and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Acts 14:22, confirming the souls of the disciples.
That's right.
And exhorting them to continue in the faith.
Thank you. We
must do much tribulation.
Much tribulation.
Enter into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God.
That's right.
Romans 8:18, for I reckon that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared with Abadiah to the glory that is to be revealed in us.
Thank you.
2 Timothy 2:1-3, he said, my son, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man at war entangle himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him that chosen to be a soldier.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Charity suffers long, saints. When you love God, you're going to suffer.
That's right.
That love will make it easy.
That's right.
That love will make 800 miles.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just about 20 or 25 miles.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. That love will make that tiredness give you some strength.
Amen.
That love will make you do it.
Love.
Amen.
Amen.
Love will make that Ethiopian eunuch come 1,000 miles. Amen.
That's right.
To worship in Jerusalem.
That's right.
That love will make the Queen of Sheba come from the uttermost parts of the world to hear the wisdom of Solomon.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And Jesus said, behold, Habatiah, greater than Solomon, is here.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
God knows what you need.
Yes, he does.
Amen. He knows how to take these people through.
Yes, he does. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen. Every last one. Amen. He said, there's not one sparrow sold for farting without the Lord knowing.
Right.
God knows his business.
Amen.
He knows how to do things.
Amen.
Amen. He knows exactly how to do it.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Well, folks don't think much of you.
Amen.
Amen. God think a lot.
Yes, he does.
Amen. God don't see it as man see it. 1 Samuel 16:7, God don't see as man see it.
No.
Samuel said, for man looking on the outward appearance. But God, Habatiah, God looking on the heart.
Hallelujah.
When they had, amen, when the Lord sent Samuel, amen, to Jesse's house.
Yes.
He said in 1 Samuel 13:14, he said, I sought a man after my own heart.
Amen.
And I, Habatiah, and I commanded him to be captain over my people. And he sent Samuel, he said, go to Jesse's house, because I got a king there in that house. And Jesse had 8 children.
Mm-hmm.
And when Samuel got there, he called for the sacrifice. And he sanctified them and brought them. And Jesse had seven of his sons to pass through.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. And the Lord told Samuel, no, that's not him. How about them?
Amen.
He said, no. He had Samuel pass through. He said, no, that's not him. Oh, and then he had another one, Eliab, to come by. And Samuel rose up and he said he was about to anoint the wrong one. And he said, surely the Lord's anointed is before me.
Amen.
And God told him, no, that's not him.
Not him.
I refuse him.
Uh-huh.
He said, because I don't see as man sees, Samuel. The man look on the outward appearance.
Uh-huh.
But I'm looking on the heart.
Amen.
And then Samuel couldn't figure the thing out. He didn't know what happened.
Amen.
He said, he asked Jesse, is this all your children?
Right.
And Jesse said, no. The youngest is out there with the sheep.
Uh-huh.
We didn't even think to call him to it.
Uh-huh.
But we didn't even think, well, I'm up there. I'm up there. Amen. And here, he said, we're not going to sit until he comes. He said, go fetch him.
Uh-huh.
And here come little David,
uh-huh,
walking in the door. As soon as he got in, God spoke to Samuel and told him, that's him, rise, right, anoint him.
Anoint him.
And he took the oil, Batia Mosia.
Hey!
He took the oil and anointed it on David's head.
Amen.
As king. Amen.
Amen.
See how God do things?
That's right.
Amen. David didn't even have to be there.
No.
Amen.
Amen. He was about doing his business.
That's right.
The Lord's business. And he told Saul, he said, let me go fight Goliath.
Uh-huh.
Let me go take him on. He already had the anointing on him.
That's right.
And he said, Saul didn't want to let him go. He said, don't you know your servant, a bear came and I slew him with my bare hand? And a lion came, and I slew him with my bare hand.
Yeah.
And this uncircumcised Philistine will be like this bear,
uh-huh,
and be like that lion.
Yes, he did say it.
Amen.
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 And he said, the Lord, how about thee, Mosea? He said, the battle is not yours.
That's right.
It is the Lord's.
Hallelujah.
God will fight for his
yes,
people.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
Yeah, but my dear.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
God knows how to make a way.
Yes, he
where
does.
Where there's no ways. If there ain't no doors there, God will put a door there.
Put a door there. Amen.
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 When he closed one door, he'll open up another one.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Don't
tell me what God can do.
That's right.
I already done found out.
Uh-huh.
I was out of work for 4 years. Down in my basement, crying unto the Lord. Amen. Going up and making trips up to Chicago with my pastor, teaching me, amen, the ministry.
Uh-huh.
Amen. He taught me, amen. I saw how his consecration, I saw how he consecrates himself, amen, before the Lord. And the life that he lives, just so he can be, amen, something that God can use to feed his people so God can work through him.
Uh-huh.
Romans 8:14 said, for as many, habatia, are led by the Spirit of God, are the sons of God.
Yeah.
Amen. You let God lead you, you can't go wrong.
That's right.
Amen. Keep your love. Amen. Keep your fire burning. Amen. Keep your love burning. Charity suffers long. And the way you know you're suffering, you can still treat the person kind. In spite of what the person's doing to you, you can still be kind to them.
Amen.
You know why? Because you got some love.
Got
that's
some
why.
Love. Amen.
You got something from upstairs.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. And they got something from downstairs.
My Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Love will do it every time. Amen.
Every time.
It covers 1 Peter 4:8. For charity covers a multitude of sins.
Yes. Amen.
No matter how much it is.
That's right.
Yep. St. John 13:34, a new commandment I give unto you,
uh-huh,
that you love one another, even as I've loved you. He said, by this man shall know that you are my disciple.
That's
how people
know.
They said, there's something
that's
different
right
about Sister So-and-so.
Uh-huh.
Amen. She must be a Christian, because she
right
got some love.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Proverbs 17:17, a friend loveth at all times. Amen. All the time, no matter what you do, your friend will be there for you.
Amen.
He love you all the time, no matter what you are.
No matter what.
Still love you.
Amen.
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 Glory to God. Amen. Finish that scripture up when we get ready. Amen. I don't want to hold it too long. Amen.
Charity envieth not.
Charity, when you got love, you're not jealous.
Amen.
Take your
amen
time.
When you got love, you're not jealous of nobody.
Amen.
Why you got to be jealous?
Take your time.
Why you got to be insecure?
Amen.
That's what happened to Cain.
Amen.
Right.
Because his brother was doing right.
Amen.
And he grows up with jealousy and kills his brother.
Right.
And his brother didn't do nothing to him.
Nothing.
All of a sudden he get up and just want to kill him. What kind of sense does that make? Charity envieth not. Charity is not jealous.
That's right.
Don't you know if God did it for one, he'll do it for the other too?
That's right.
Amen.
That's
what
right.
What God has for you is going to be yours. You don't have to steal it.
No. Nope.
You don't have to kill nobody else.
That's right.
You ain't running for office here. You ain't no politician. Amen. You don't need to slander nobody.
That's right.
Just be who you are.
That's right. Be yourself.
Amen. God use who he wants. Amen. He'll use a donkey if you want.
Uh-huh.
He'll make a donkey talk.
That's right.
He said, I'll make the rocks cry out.
Amen.
Amen. Remember Balak?
Amen.
Amen. Charity envieth not. Read.
Charity vaunteth not itself.
Charity does not puff itself up. You're always lifting yourself up.
Uh-huh.
I'm the boss. What's everybody doing?
Uh-huh.
Amen. Want to micromanage everything.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God the Lord blessed me to be over 13 engineers. Amen. They got degrees. Amen. They're old men. Amen. And the Lord blessed me
uh-huh.
to be a manager in two departments.
Okay.
And I don't micromanage them either.
Thank you, Lord.
Sometimes they need to micromanage them.
Yeah.
Anymore, but
yeah.
I let them be who they are. Let their personality, right. let them be do their work.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I ain't no bossy boss.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Read.
Wonderful.
It's not puffed up. It's not proud.
Amen.
High minded.
Yeah.
Because you got a title. Some folks give themselves a title.
Yeah. Amen.
Let God give you the title.
Amen.
Let God do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Psalm 127:1, except the Lord have a Habakkuk, build this house. The labor in vain that building. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waking in vain.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Let the Lord do it. Wait on God and he'll do it right.
Yes, he will.
God is a God of order, not the author of confusion.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't have to be scared of nobody. Amen. What God has for you is yours.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Your gifts will make room for you.
Amen.
God knows where to put his people.
Thank you, Lord.
He knows what his people need. This is his business. This is his work.
Amen.
Amen. That's what Jesus was about, the Lord's business.
Amen.
When they were looking for him, when he was 12 years old, they were looking for him.
Amen.
And he was about, he told his parents, don't you know I'm about my father's business?
Amen.
And some of these young folks, they don't even, Jesus was 12 years old about his father's business. These young folks, they don't know nothing about their father's business.
Amen.
They're concerned about the church.
Amen.
They're concerned about God's word.
Amen.
They're concerned about their souls being saved.
Amen.
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 Let's get right, church, and go home.
Yes, Lord.
Finish up.
Amen.
I'm almost
would
through.
Would not behave itself unseemly. Seeketh not her own. Is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil.
You see how love is? You can tell when a person loves you.
Amen.
Person don't say praise the Lord to you and don't even come shake your hand. What kind of message does that send you?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
You're so busy you can't shake the hands with the saints?
That's right.
My Lord.
Praise the Lord?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You saw all that you can't praise the Lord with the saints?
Amen.
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 Hebrew 13:1, be careful how thou entertainest strangers.
That's right.
Some have entertained angels
unaware.
Folks get caught up in themselves so much. Amen. Lord, I hope I don't never do that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Stay low.
Amen.
Stay humble. That's the way to go up.
Amen.
Jesus said, lo, I come in the volume of the books. It's written of me. I come to do thy will.
Mm.
He stayed humble.
Yes, he did.
And he was obedient.
Amen.
Amen. Finish up.
Rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth.
All right, God bless you. I'm through. I don't want to wear your patience. Amen. It's a weekend, y'all. Some got to drive. Amen. Got to have love. Amen. Amen. Children got school. Got to have love and sense and some wisdom and knowledge. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, Brother Armani. Amen.
Amen. Amen.